Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. How are you, students? Today we will study unit number 1. Subject physics. Chapter name is measurement. Today topic is precision and accuracy. Precision and accuracy. In daily life, precision and accuracy mean same thing, but precision of a measurement is associated with the least count of measuring instrument. Accuracy is associated with the magnitude of fractional error or relative error in that measurement. For percentage fractional uncertainty also. So if you want to calculate precision of a measuring instrument, you should look to the least count. Less will be the least count, more will be the precision. For example, you have two instruments, vernier caliper and screw gauge. The least count of screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter. And the least count of vernier caliper is 0.1 millimeter. So, if you look to the screw gauge least count, the least count of screw gauge, it is less than the least count of vernier caliper. So less will be the least count, more will be the precision. More will be the precision, more precise will be the data. And accuracy depend on fractional uncertainty. Fractional uncertainty. So fractional uncertainty or relative error or percentage fractional uncertainty. We will calculate this thing. So percentage I will write this symbol. For fractional I will write F, and for uncertainty I will write U. It is equal to the least count of measuring instrument divided by measured value multiplied by 100%. So, percentage fractional uncertainty can be calculated by dividing least count by measured value and multiplied by 100%, or just calculate the fractional uncertainty. Z equal to least count divided by measured value. This will be the fractional uncertainty, or less will be the percentage fractional uncertainty, more will be the accuracy. The data might be, if you make two measurement with one with vernier caliper and one with screw gauge, the vernier caliper might be more accurate and the screw gauge might be not more accurate. So, but the data measured by screw gauge will be more precise as compared to the data measured by vernier caliper, because precision is different in physics than accuracy. Precision in screw gauge, the least count of screw gauge is lesser, so it will be surely more precise as compared to the vernier caliper. You cannot make decision according to your own wishes. You have definitions and rule for precision and for accuracy. You have different rule, so you should decide the precision and accuracy according to the definition of precision and accuracy and according to the rule of precision and accuracy. The rule for to decide the precision is to look to the least count of instrument. Less will be the least count, more will be the precision. The least count of screw gauge is lesser, so it will be more precise. And the least count of vernier caliper is more, so it will be less precise as compared to the screw gauge. And the data measured by vernier caliper might be more accurate than the data measured by screw gauge. Might be the screw gauge data will be more precise and more accurate. It depends on the fractional uncertainty. Less will be the fractional uncertainty, more will be the precision, more will be the accuracy. So accuracy can be purely decided on fractional uncertainty, and precision can be purely decided on percentage fractional uncertainty. On percentage fractional uncertainty, more will be the less will be the less will be the least count, more will be the precision. Less will be the fractional uncertainty, more will be the accuracy. Precision does not mean accuracy, but both are highly demanded. While making measurement in physics, they both can be readily understood as smaller the least count of measuring instrument, better will be its precision. Similarly, smaller the magnitude of fractional or relative error, better will be the accuracy in the measuring instrument. Precision is also indicated by the magnitude of uncertainty in a measuring instrument. It is a IS. It's also IS. So remember that precision precisions depend on least count. Less will be the least count, more will be the precision. More will be the precision. So the screw gauge is more precise as compared to the vernier caliper. And accuracy. In accuracy, accuracy depend on fractional uncertainty. It is divided by least count, divided by calculated value or measured value. If you multiply by 100%, here you will write percentage fractional uncertainty. Percentage fractional uncertainty. Now, in the given experiment, the reading taken by two different with different time devices are T1 is equal to 2.5, T2 is equal to 32.54, and T3 is equal to this. This is with one instrument, this is with other instrument, this is with other instrument. Find the total time up to correct precision. So if you look to the data, you have three observations. In this, there are four significant figures. In this, there are four significant figures. And in this, there are two significant figures. So you should limit your answers to two significant figures, because the minimum accurate, the number of minimum accurate measurement with you is two digits. From the point, you have only from the decimal point to one digit. So you will limit it to from the point, you will limit it to one digit, to first digit. Solution. The total time is T is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. So you take the sum 2.5, 32.54, 10.52, and so on. Total time is 45.56 seconds. According to the rules discussed above, the least precise number is T1, which is 2.5. Thus, we round up their sum to one digit after decimal point, that is to 45.6. After point, the accuracy is only to one digit, not to two or three, because this is the least accurate measurement. Least the measurement which have least number of significant figure. So from the decimal place, it is limited to first digit. Now, the diameter of a solid sphere measured with vernier caliper is this one. This is the diameter. And its length is this one. Find its volume to the possible accuracy. The possible accuracy. So from the point it is limited to three digit. It is limited to three digit. From the point it is limited to two digit. Total is three digit. So solution is volume of solid cylinder is pi r square L. Pi r square L. This is the volume of cylinder. Formula for the volume of cylinder. You should calculate radius. Radius from the diameter. So diameter should be divided by 2. This is the diameter. So it should be divided by 2. It is divided by 2. 2.20 centimeter divided by 2 is equal to 1.10 centimeter. Thus. Volume is equal to 22 divided by 7 multiplied by, this is the value of pi. This is radius. Square of radius, so radius. And this is 3.52, this is length. You will get volume. 33.3860571.4 centimeter cube. So, the answer is 33. There are three significant figure, both in R is equal to 1.10 and L is equal to 3.52 centimeter. Thus, the number of significant figure in volume should not increase than three. Therefore, we rounded up the result to three significant figure, which is 13.4 centimeter cube. The answer is rounded to three significant figure because it contains three significant figure. It also contains three significant figure. In the first experiment, example 1.1, we calculate the precision. We calculate the correct precision, and here we calculate the find its volume to the possible accuracy. So that's why 1.1 is treated differently and 1.2 is treated differently. Now calculating uncertainty in the final result. So in next lecture we will do the indicating, indicating uncertainty. Now we are dealing to calculate precision and accuracy and uncertainty in the final result. Calculating uncertainty in the final result. Let x, y and z are three different physical quantities. This will be the uncertainty in this measurement, and in this measurement the uncertainty is this one, and z is the uncertainty in this one, or the uncertainty in them respectively. Rules for addition and subtraction. First we will calculate the uncertainty in addition and subtraction. You have x is equal to y plus z. Y plus z. Or you make the subtraction. Let x be the final result obtained due to the addition and our subtraction of y and z. This is the final result. Whether you make addition or you make subtraction. This is represents the final result. And del y represents the uncertainty in this observation, and this represents the uncertainty in this one, in this measurement. Y and Z are the observation, are the measured values. Now, detail of this rule. For rules for addition and subtraction, detail, explanation with example. D1 is the observation whose value is this one, and del D1 is the uncertainty. D2 is the measured value and del 2 is the observation. This is the uncertainty. This is the measured value. Represents the internal diameter of emitter ring, and D2 plus minus del D2 is equal to 30 plus minus 0.1 centimeter, represents the external diameter of a metal ring, and find the thickness of the ring along with uncertainty in it. So let T and del T represents the thickness and uncertainty in thickness. To find the thickness, we know that thickness here is represented by T. So thickness is the difference. Thickness is the difference between the two measured values, between internal diameter and external diameter, and divided by 2. So it's 3 centimeter. So here we make this the subtraction. So the rule for subtraction is uncertainty in the thickness is both the uncertainties should be added. Both the uncertainty should be added. So 0.1, this is 0.1, and this is also 0.1. So it will increase the uncertainty. So in addition, the uncertainty increases. In subtraction, the uncertainty also increases. Whether you make subtraction or whether you make addition, the uncertainty will be double. The uncertainty will increase, because the first data is uncertain. The second data is also uncertain. If first data is 24 centimeter, it is uncertain to 0.1 centimeter. If the second data is 30 centimeter and it is uncertain to 0.1 centimeter, so both the data are uncertain. So it will increase the uncertainty. It will not decrease the uncertainty. So uncertainty will be increased by in addition and in subtraction. Product and quotient rule, this is very important. If you have x is equal to yz, x is equal to yz, or x is equal to y divided by z. If you have this equation or this equation, whatever the equation is, these are only the supposed equation. The percentage uncertainty in the x is the percentage uncertainty in y and percentage uncertainty in z, because x is the product of y and z. So in this, it is, if it is uncertain, and this is also uncertain, so it is the result of these two. So the uncertainty of x and y will be added. So uncertainty will be added. If it is in division, if it is equal to y divided by z, so it is also the result of y and z. The result of y and z, it is uncertain. Again, the uncertainty will be added. So if a quantity is the result of two quantities, the uncertainty in the resultant quantity will be the sum of the individual uncertainties. So here volume is equal to IR. We have to calculate uncertainty in the result, in the resistance. Volume voltage is equal to 7.3, and this is the uncertainty. The least count of measuring instrument. The current is this one, and it is the uncertainty in the current. So R, first you will calculate R resistance, which is 7.3 divided by 2.73. So it is divided by this, you will get this one. This is the uncertainty, this is the resistance. When voltage is 7.3 and current is 2.73 ampere, the resistance will be 2.7. Now, you will calculate percentage uncertainty in volume, percentage frictional uncertainty in volume. So least count will be divided by measured value multiplied by 100%. You will get the percentage uncertainty. And this is the rounded value. So the uncertainty in volume is this one, 1%. And the percentage uncertainty in the current is the least count of current is divided by the measured value of current multiplied by 100%. 0.05 divided by 2.73. This is the measured value and this is the least count. So it is divided by 100%, multiplied by 100%. This is the resultant value. So it is multiplied with 2%. You will get the 2%. Rounded value is 2%. So 1% and 2% is 3%. So resistance is the result of voltage and current. So the uncertainty in the voltage, which is 1%, and uncertainty in the current, which is 2%, will be added up. The total uncertainty will be 3%. So the uncertainty in the result, in the resistance, will be the sum of the uncertainty in the voltage and uncertainty in the current. So this is the uncertainty in voltage and this is the uncertainty in the current. Their sum is this one, which is 3% rounded value. So this is the uncertainty, which is 3% in the del R is equal to 3%. Will be multiplied by 100% and divided by the measured value of resistance. So you will get the uncertainty in the resistance, which is 0.08%. So the value the value of resistance, which we calculated by R is equal to VI, is uncertain to up to 0.08. The uncertainty in 2.7 is 0.08, and the percentage uncertainty is 100%. The percentage uncertainty is 3%. If resistance is 100 ohm, it will be either 97 or it will be 103. This 3 means it will be 3 more or 3 less. 3 more or 3 less. This is the actual value, or between these two values. 3% represent this one. Yes, this value is less than 100. So uncertainty will be less. Thank you, students. Next, we will in next lecture we will go into detail of this topic. Further detail.